So listen, we just got a hot tip that Tom Cruise and Katie Holmes are actually in the area and going to get married within the next few days. And so the trick first is to find them. Should be a little easier than finding Osama bin Laden. So who's got an idea for a writer?
I've got the perfect writer in mind. Let
you
me call
do?
My freelancers. Yeah.
Oh, wait. I think this could be my big break, my big story.
Hey, I talk of the town. I stalk celebrities every month. If there's Tom Cruise, it should be me.
Listen, I think we're going to have to arm wrestle for this one to see who gets to do it. But in the meantime, Shelley, would you check your files?
I'm on the phone.
Okay. Go do it.
I can't believe what I heard. Sundler is trying to keep that story all to himself.
There's so much business possibility in that we could get out of there. I mean, the tourism, the film industry.
Well, I think as editors of the magazine, we need to make our argument that the story belongs in ours. Well, let's put this together and we'll just have to go over Sundler's head.
Okay. Because we could get some really good sidebars going with this, too, you know, on all the different tangents, like the paparazzi coming, you know, what kind of economic boost is that going to feed into the hotel?
Oh, we could do something on the business of Scientology.
Right. Boy, that could be a whole new angle into sort of the religion and the business of religion.
All right. I think we got it.
Okay.
I'm Tracy Jones. I'm the senior editor of Gulf Shore Life, and among all the many things I do, I also coordinate all of the society and the photography, and also do the Talk of the Town column, where I always try to get my celebrity, and I know how to do that.
Hey, Don, how are you? This is Tracy Jones from Gulf Shore Life, and somebody just mentioned that they were at a dinner that you did last night, and it just reminded me when they talked about your steak tornadoes that I've been meaning to call you. There's a house that you told me about in Port Royal where they rent it out for beach weddings, and somebody from another charity was asking me about that. Do you have that address? Okay. All right. Well, thank you very much. All right. Good to talk to you. Thanks. Bye-bye.
That's how I find out things. I'm on my way to the beach.
No, look. It's Tom and Katie. What do you mean your computer's broken? I don't care. Write it out longhand. Just get me the story.
I like the fight, but are you winning? Did you get the story? Come on.
I'm the fact checker and copy editor, so I will find everything there is to know about Tom Cruise before noon. Hey, Tracy, it's Becca. I know you're on the way to the beach, but I already found Tom Cruise's mom's address on the property appraiser's website. Here it is.
I didn't get any of my stuff read today.
I didn't edit not even one article today.
I have 1,500 words to write about custom jewelry by 8 a.m.
Well, you're gonna love this. This just in on the email. Hey, Mom. I was researching my novel in the Outer Islands and ran into Tom and Katie. They let me snap the wedding. Hope you can use this in place of my travel story. P.S. They're naming the baby after me. Cheers, Bob Morris, your only on the Gulf Shore loyal correspondent. We're supposed to be happy here, right?
Yeah. That's great. Go, Bob. Yeah.
That's my boy, Bob.
I'm Tessa Tilden Smith, creative director for the magazine, and I assign all the photography for Gulf Shore Life. I choose photographers, I lay out most of the magazine. I thought that this was going to be an easy day. And I think it's going to be a hey, Dave.
Hello there, my art colleagues.
How's that?
I got news for you, and it isn't good.
Our
friend Bob Morris and Tom Cruise and Katie Holmes, well, Laptop stolen, no interview. Digital camera gone, no photos. So it looks as if we're out of business.
Well, what happened?
Well, what's happened is there's no Tom Cruise and Katie Holmes.
Oh, that's terrible. So we've got no cover.
A magazine without a cover, imagine that.
Oh, well.
Yes.
You want to go out and stand in front of the newsstand and entertain the troops?
Hello? Oh, hey. Hi, Lynn. Really? At the Ritz? Are you sure? Tom Cruise? That's amazing. Oh, I've got to tell David. Thanks. Bye.
We coming through to take control of each zip code. Bridging the gap from rap to calypso. We're gonna strike each city.
You won't believe this. I just got a call from Lynn at the Ritz. She said she just saw Tom Cruise in the lobby. Huh. You know, I've
never
just...
say that.
Well, if I can get pictures, if I can get a photographer over there, could we run a story on the honeymoon?
Absolutely.
Okay, great. Well,
we're ever resourceful here.
Okay, well, yeah. I'm going to go down there and make sure that it was Tom Cruise and not a lookalike.
All right, well, that's great news.
Okay.
Good going.
Thanks. I got the call from Lynn that Tom Cruise and Katie Holmes were honeymooning at the Ritz. I thought, this is going to be great. You know, we were planning on covering their wedding until Bob Morris, hanging out in some bar in the islands, got his camera and laptop stolen. So we had nothing. Then Lynn saw them at the Ritz. We rushed over there. I managed to see that that was Tom and Katie.
Oh, that looks like Tom and Katie over there.
Hey, we got
them. Are you sure that's them? They don't look really like... Yeah. Yeah, that's them, but...
Who's that with him? That hair or that...
Yeah. Dude, that's Donald Trump!
Oh,
Trump!
While we were at the Ritz, you won't believe what happened. Jesse spotted Donald Trump.
That's Donald Trump!
And he raced off. I mean, I didn't know what he was doing. I thought he was going to tackle the guy. But he thought that this might be a story Phil would be interested in Gulf Shore Business. And, you know, in the art department, we're not usually the people who come up with the stories, but we just happened to be at the right place in the right time.
As soon as I saw Donald Trump at the Ritz, I knew I had to go meet him. Turns out he's in town promoting riverboat gambling in downtown Fort Myers, and I knew Phil would be ecstatic if we got the story. So there you have it. It's the next cover story for Gulf Shore Business Magazine.
So I came back to my computer with a lot of Tom and Katie pictures, but you know, we didn't really like the way that they looked.
Oh, wow. This is terrible. So, Tessa, do we have some winners? How are we doing here?
Disaster. You said Katie must have put on like 50 pounds, and Tom, is he really that small? He looks like a midget.
Must be more than a baby. She's gone in there, maybe two or three.
I don't know what we're going to do. I knew that it would take a lot of retouching to get the pictures where we wanted for a cover. Huh. You know, this is going to take a lot of retouching. To run these pictures, I'm going to have to talk to Richard. It's going to be a lot of work. But, you know, don't worry about the rest of the magazine. Now we've got Eric here. He can lay out everything else.
Our hero, Eric.
Oh, Eric, you won't believe what happened.
Oh, hey, Tessa, what's up?
And, these Tom and Katie pictures are terrible. And it's going to take so much work to do this story. It's going to take all my time. You're going to have to lay out the rest of the magazine.
Okay. Yeah. No problem.
Look, it's not that much. You can do it. I had to get my new employee, Eric, to lay out the rest of the magazine, but I knew he could handle it. You know, it's only like 5 features in 20 departments. I mean, he's a newspaper guy. I knew that would be no problem.
Hey, I'm Eric Raditz, and I'm the new guy, assistant art director to Gulf Shore Life. And being here a week, it was a little bit surprising that Tom Cruise and Katie Holmes were, in fact, in town. So initially I was very excited until I realized that I was going to have to design the whole magazine. And I'm pro. I mean, I can do it, but it's just, for her to throw that at me like that, I was just like, all right. I mean, we're a team and everyone seems to get along, and that's how things get done around here. So I rolled up my sleeves.
And then the next thing was, We have everything all set for our best cover ever. And David comes up and tells me that People magazine is scooping us.
I've been talking to some folks I know in New York, and now I hear that People magazine, which has comparable pictures to ours, being a weekly magazine, is going to beat us to the newsstand.
No, you're kidding.
So unless we have some grand new plan, we've been beat.
Oh, well, that would be terrible. Yeah. Well, let me see what I can do. Maybe if we push up our schedule by a week, if we get everything to the printer a week earlier, would we be able to beat People?
We would indeed, and nothing would please us more than to beat People.
Well,
the big guys.
We're going to try our best. Let me go and talk to Amy. We have a great team in the art department, and I know that Amy can work miracles with deadlines. So I go and tell her if there's any way we can get the magazine out a week earlier, we can scoop People magazine. Oh, you won't believe what happened.
What?
We've got a chance to put Tom and Katie on the cover. They're honeymooning at the Ritz. But we just heard that People magazine is going to have it on the cover. We need to push up our schedule. Is there any way we can do that, like gain a week?
So we need to get the magazine out a week early.
Yeah, roughly a week.
Tessa came to me and told me that we needed to get the magazine out a week early. I knew that it was going to be another all-nighter for me. So as advertising art director, I build all the ads for the magazine and put them in the magazine, but I also have to process all the pages and keep us on schedule, so a page doesn't leave here unless I look at it. So I've got my work cut out for me.
How are the, is there anything that we can do?
The only way we can do it is to white line tomorrow.
Well, I guess if we worked all night, the four of us, we could probably do that.
Okay, well, we're gonna have to send an email out. We'll have to white line tomorrow, that's the only way. Okay. We're a little short on ads, but we can add those at Colorproof.
Okay. Well, I think
I'm up for it. Let's do it.
Okay, great. Thanks. It's really all about teamwork, and we've got two great covers, Gulf Shore Business and Gulf Shore Life.